Hey everyone, today's video is a tag video and it's the one going around called Beauty Things That I Suck At. And I was tagged by Sani of Miss May 27. If you are not subscribed to her, I'll put her link below. You've got to go subscribe to her. She is a makeup artist living in Paris, France. She does wonderful tutorials. She's a beautiful blonde. She's really easy to listen to and there's just like a sweetness about her that makes her so fun to watch. So if you're not subscribed, you should definitely go check her out. I love the idea of this tag because so many times we come on here and offer tips and tricks on things that we think we're good at, or at least we're, you know, halfway good at, and a lot of times we don't do the things that we're not really good at. So I thought it was fun to play along with this. So there are many things that I suck at, but the first one that I really suck at is winged eyeliner on myself. Now you give me a 16-year-old and I do their makeup for prom, I can do a winged eyeliner on a young eyelid, no problem. Doing it on myself is a totally different story because I've got mature, hooded eyes. I think this one goes down a little bit more. So whenever I try to wing it out, if I try to wing it up and follow my bottom lash line up, by the time I open my eyes, it's gone. You can't see it unless I close my eyes and then you can see it. Or if I try to wing it out, then it just looks weird on me. So I am not great at doing a winged liner on myself. And I think it was Sani who said she was going to put out a winged liner for hooded eyes video, so you can bet I will be watching that one. The next thing that I suck at is anything to do with my nails. So my nails, here they are, I usually either I don't have polish on them just because I don't want to draw attention to them, or if I have polish on them, it will be a light color like OPI Bubble Bath or an Essie, I think it's called like Ballerina or something like that. My nails suck. And I suck at doing them. I can't even file them. Next thing you know, I filed the whole thing down. The other thing is my cuticles seem to grow over my nail. Now, I know there's a bunch of different philosophies about whether or not to cut your cuticles or not. I'm one that I have to go in and I ask them to trim back my cuticles because when I leave, they look so great. But then the next day, it's like this vicious cycle. They start growing out again and the cuticles are all, you know, coming out. So I suck at doing my nails and that's why normally you'll see that I don't have anything on my nails or a light color. Now my toes, I usually go and get a pedicure for that, so I can change the polish and that type of thing. I can polish my nails. I just can't shape them or do anything with cuticles, that type of thing. The next thing that I suck at is a smooth ponytail for me and my daughter. For some reason, when we put ponytails in, there are bumps. It's either a bump on the bottom or it's like a bump on the top. I don't know if it's because we have naturally curly hair or we've got calyx in certain places. I can do a smooth ponytail on most other people, especially if they've got fine straight hair, that's easy. But on ourselves, we cannot make a ponytail that's not bumpy. And luckily right now, a lot of the trends are, you know, a poofy, I hate that word because I can't say it right, poofy ponytail, or, you know, something that looks a little bit messy. So those are easy for me to do. But anything slick back on me or my daughter, forget it. I can't really do it well at all. Next thing I suck at is, well, actually, let me tell you something first, and that is I've never had a spray tan. I've experimented with things out of the bottle like Jergens and that type of thing, but I've never had a spray tan because I'm nervous I'm going to end up with orange palms. To me, I would rather be pale than have the fake-looking tan with the orange palms. I just think, I don't know, I think it, I don't like it. So I suck at even putting the Jergens on, and now they make a new formula that's odor-free, by the way, that's much better than the original one. But no matter what, I'll exfoliate, I'll shave before, and when I put it on, it's still, I'll end up with splotches. So I suck at fake tanning, and I'm so scared to try. I think I got sent a sample of the Saint-Tropez, and I looked in the bottle, and that stuff looks dark brown, scares the heck out of me, so I have never even tried to do that because I'm afraid I'm going to end up orange and spotty. So I suck at fake tanning. The next thing I suck at is trimming and plucking my own brows if it's been too long in between a professional service. So if I go and have my brows professionally done, I can go in there and pluck a random hair and trim the hairs and keep them pretty decent looking. Now, if I go a couple months without going to a professional, then I start plucking and just you know, trying to trim, and they just become a big mess. Now, I have gotten better over the years because I did buy the Anastasia brow little stencils, and there was only one in that whole thing that came close to fitting my eyebrow. And I'll have to show it in another video, but if I use that, then I can kind of follow along the line. So I have gotten better, although it's one of those things that I think I still suck at. So I love this video. I think it's so fun to talk about things that we're not great at doing. So if you want to do this, I would love to hear from you. And what I'll do is, I know a lot of people have already been tagged for this video, but I'll put some names of people that I tag that I would love to hear from. And like I said, if you want to do it, please do it. And just attach it to this video. So I hope y'all are having a great day, and I will talk to you soon. Thanks for watching. Bye.